Secretary of Defense of the United States, the Honorable Lloyd J. Austin III, and Secretary of National Defense of the Philippines, the Honorable Gilberto C. Teodoro Jr.
America is profoundly committed to the defense of the Philippines. Our commitment to the Mutual Defense Treaty is ironclad. And let me say again that the Mutual Defense Treaty applies to armed attacks on either of our armed forces, aircraft, or public vessels, including our coast guards, anywhere in the South China Sea.
We have heard that in recent months China has been more aggressive in the South China Sea. Can you tell us what's happened and what the response has been, U.S. and Philippine side?
Well, it's the same story over and over again. They have been more aggressive in denying us access to our exclusive economic zone in the West Philippine Sea. They have really placed a lot of these pseudo-military vessels disguised as Coast Guard vessels and maritime militia vessels in the areas in the West Philippine Sea. They have been very aggressive in their information operations against the Philippines.
The behavior of the PRC has been concerning. You've heard me say that a number of times. They've used dangerous and escalatory measures to enforce their expansive South China Sea maritime claims. When it comes to what we will do, I won't speculate about any hypotheticals when it comes to our mutual defense treaty, but we have emphasized, and you heard me just emphasize it a couple of minutes ago, that we remain committed to the treaty. We stand with the Philippines, and we condemn dangerous actions by the PRC against lawful Philippine operations in the South China Sea. Again, this is concerning behavior, and we've made this point to our Chinese counterparts a number of times in a number of forums. So, again, we'll continue to work with our allies and make sure that we're doing the right things to promote a secure and open Indo-Pacific. That's really important to everyone in this region.
Then again, in so far as the Philippines is concerned and in partnership with the United States, our main theme of cooperation here, aside from being treaty allies, stands firm. Upholding of international law and the fundamental and the values of freedom and democracy. Thank you.
The strength of our alliance, I think, will transcend changes of administration going forward. So, again, I won't speculate on any changes in policy or any anything that the new administration may bring on board. What I will tell you is that this is an important country, not only to me, but to people in both parties back in the United States of America.